Do you run the other way when you hear the word composing? Hello, Harpers. I'm Tiffany Schaefer, and today we're going to talk about what is a dreaded word for so many of us. If you like the idea of composing, but you just think you're not good at it, stick around. The comment question today is, do you compose? And if you don't, why not? For me, for many years, my why not was, I just wasn't good at it. I'm fine with arranging other people's tunes and coming up with creative ideas that way, but composing? Oh, that takes a special talent, something you're just born with. And I felt this way until one year I found myself in a workshop with Haley Hewitt. She introduced this idea I had never seen before, something you could call round robin composing. There were several harpers in a big circle, and one person came up with just one short phrase. Then the next person in line continued it with another very short phrase. Before you knew it, we had a tune that was taking on its own characteristics and sounded pretty great. That was the first time I had really conceptualized that composing doesn't have to be a huge daunting task if you take it one phrase at a time, even three or four notes at a time. And there's no right or wrong way of doing it because it's your tune, and you can always change something if you don't like how it sounds. You can't be afraid of hitting a wrong note or a note that sounds bad because you're not gonna get very far. So what if you like this idea of team composing, but you don't have a circle of harpers around you who can give you a phrase to continue? I'm going to show you a quick hack, a little trick that you can use for a similar effect all on your own, and it's called name composing. Now, this isn't something that I made up, but I think it's a really great idea to sort of jog your creative juices and get them flowing. So I'm going to walk you through how to do it today. And there is a chart, which I'll link below in the description, that I've made so you can have it handy for reference. So you might want to download that if you're going to try this right now and have it in front of you. I'm going to have my chart that you can download for free up here on the screen so you can see the principle of what we're talking about. Now, if I want to compose a tune, or at least start a phrase using the letters of my name, obviously there's no T in the musical alphabet, there's no N, there's no Y, there's no I. So this chart is what's going to help us decode and sort of decide what letters to use instead. So you can see that finding the T for my name directly above that in the musical alphabet is an F. So instead of a T, I'm going to use an F, and I've already written that down. Instead of an I, if you look at the chart for an I, right above that is a B. So I'm going to use a B in place of the I. Then I'll use two Fs because there are two Fs in Tiffany, and also there are Fs in the musical alphabet. So I'll use those. Same for an A, we'll use an A. And then instead of an N, it's gonna have me use a G instead. And instead of a Y, follow it up, it's gonna be a D instead. So T-I-F-F-A-N-Y becomes F-B-F-F-A-G-D. So I'm just going to play those notes, and I'll start with sort of the bass key of C and just see what that sounds like. F, B, F, F, A, G, D. Odd, a little avant-garde. So if I don't really like how that sounds right off the bat, experiment with not only levers, we can definitely experiment with that. Let's try making our F sharp. So that sounds much better to my ear, and I think that we would be sort of in a home key. Right here, of B minor. Kind of fiddle around and see that that sort of sounds like the home key we would be in. So if I'm going to play this in B minor and write a tune in B minor, then I want to have both my Fs and my Cs sharp. And we're going to play that again. F, B, F, F, A, G, D. Now I'm starting to have something that I can work with. And it's a phrase I didn't have to make up. It's something the chart gave me. Another idea you can think about when just starting out with this phrase is playing around with the octave that your note is in. So I don't have to start in that middle F and go up. I could maybe start in this higher F. F, B, F, F, A, G, D. Or I could do one of the Fs high and one of the Fs lower. So I've cheated a bit and I've already made up a tune using my name phrase a while ago. So I'll show you, I'll walk you sort of through the process of how I decided to continue it. First of all, because there are seven letters, I decided on a 3-4 sort of pattern, or 6-8. 3-4-5-6. 1-2-3-4-5. So it sounded a bit like a jig to me, and I wanted to keep that idea going. And just add a few more notes. We're still sort of in that home key of B minor. And then I just repeated that whole entire phrase because why not? And I figured we can change up chords here too. It doesn't have to be the same chord every time. More on chords later. There will be another video coming up in the next few months, hopefully, about going a little more in depth about how to find chords, chord progressions, all that fun stuff. For now, I will link a video up in the cards that may help you with that. So check it out if you haven't seen it. Now I needed another phrase to complete it and get us back to home. So I decided to go up since I hadn't done that very much in this tune. It's sort of been going downward. And you can really just think about, there's no wrong note here, there's no right note. Your key is set, you know your key. So just sort of run up and down and see what jumps out to you. So that was the phrase I went with next. Then I went down to a D. Then I decided to wrap it up with a familiarity, sort of from the beginning tune. Then I decided to repeat that phrase. So all together, the whole tune came out sounding like this. It should be faster, but you get the idea. Now, of course, this doesn't have to be your name either. Using this chart, you could use your significant other's name. You could use your mother's name. You could use your dog's name. You could use a word of something you like. You could use pizza. You could use tree. Let's try tree. Now, I've never done this word before, so we're gonna do this cold and see how it turns out. So according to our chart, a T again would turn into F, and then the R would turn into D, and then of course two E's. So we would have F, D, E, E. Let's try around with different levers. Instead of having our Fs up, let's try having F natural. Let's try playing around with the octave. Mm-hmm. camera was away, I made another decision that I think we're going to stick in the key of D for this word, tree. For me, anyway. So that F sharp is in the key of D. Let's maybe start with that. And then it's wanting to go to A for me. Again, there's no right, there's no wrong. You might take this word and come up with a totally different tune, and I would love to see that, by the way. So tag me in it on Instagram or on Facebook if you end up doing a name composing or a word composing tune because of this video. I'd really love to see it. You can tag me on Instagram at Tiffany Harpist, or on Facebook, I'm at facebook.com/TiffanySchaeferHarp. Really, all this does, it helps take away some of the decision fatigue that comes when you're trying to compose a tune. I've used the same principle with wind chimes before. There's a place where John and I go for our anniversary. We've been there 2 or 3 times, and there's just a little wind chime shop. And there's all kinds of large and small wind chimes in there. So I like to go in there and be inspired and see if there's a snatch of melody somewhere in there. And sometimes that's all you need. Let me know in the comments if you tried this idea and if you like it. If you want to talk with other harpers about ideas like this and you don't have anyone in your area, try joining our monthly meetup. Every month on a Saturday afternoon, a group of my patrons and I meet and chat and get to know each other and talk about any harp-related topics that we might want to discuss. Our next meeting is going to be this coming Saturday, April 20th at 2 p.m. EST. And there's a link below in the description on how you can join if you're interested in that. Maybe we'll even try round robin composing sometime. If you want to see more videos about harp topics, click right over there. If you want to subscribe so you don't miss next week's video, click my face. And if you want to join our monthly meetup or see what other rewards I have on Patreon, you can click right up there. I'll see you next week. Bye!